should have done that. I'm not a gentleman.
I'm reaching across you, which technically is
very nice.
What concerns me about PBS is he makes 5 and 7 minute projects. You make 4 hour projects, which I love, you know. But again, I'm not in that kid's generation. I'm not in your generation, and I'm not really in her generation either. We're all 4 different generations here.
Should we just come out with it?
No, we don't have to.
You gonna Chiron it or something?
No. But that just dated you right there. When you said Chiron, he doesn't even know what that is.
I know, but I'm just barely enough.
I started with the Chiron.
He started before a Chiron.
I started. You still use gaffer tape?
Yeah.
You do? Oh, that's cool.
How would gaffer tape go out of style?
Gaffer tape's crucial.
Gaffer tape is so crucial.
Even if you're not in film, you need gaffer tape.
Do you still use tripods?
Hey, man.
No one else does.
Do you use tripods is the question.
Of course.
Yeah, well, I know lots of young filmmakers that don't.
You know,
they don't. They got all kinds of rules. No tripods, no lighting.
Oh, rules, come on. Why? What?
I'm with you. I think rules.
It's just,
I mean, it's hard enough to make a decent film.
Demand.
What the hell do you want rules for? Yeah.
But, I mean, really, in the end, we've got all this great new technology, but it's about, you know, using it to tell a story. What I think is happening is that you've got a generation that's growing up, like from 10 years old, they have these cameras in their hands, and they can work with them, and they can play with them, and they can edit. And like, you know, by the time they're 21 years old, they're gonna have the form down. You know, it's like Michelangelo did the Pietà, he's 21. He'd been working since he was 10. I mean, now it's so available.
I say so.
There's gonna be a lot better filmmakers.
But the storytellers still emerge. The great storytellers will still emerge. The digital revolution changed everything. Are you kidding me? It made everybody a reporter and everybody a filmmaker.
Yeah, but I go with your first statement. There are five people that are great.
Yeah, then the great ones come out. And thanks to festivals and certain curating bodies, you could grow up in a trailer, you know, in the middle of bumfuck wherever and be a genius and actually be recognized now. Before, you couldn't. Now you can afford that $100 camera. You know?
And another thing that happens is that you've got people that can go out for their first film and they've got their camera and they're committed, they're passionate, and they spend a year, 2, 3 years collecting this stuff. But they really don't know how to tell the story and they didn't quite have a point of view, but then they get one of these great editors who've been around, you know, since my time, you know. You know, some of the great people, you know, the Bob Eisenarts or the Jeff Bartzes and they throw it at them, and then they work with them, but these people know how to tell the story. And the beginning filmmaker then learns from these old editing pros who take this stuff, and you know, they spend a year with it and make it into
stuff. Or 4.
I mean, I personally am probably I'm a little more pessimistic about it. I'm saying, yes, there's lots of, I know some people are very fearful of all these kids with cameras. I'm not fearful with it, you know.
Why are they fearful?
Oh, they think that there's going to be so much more content. It's going to be so much harder to be up at the top of the ladder. I mean, it's always going to be.
It's like anything.
Yeah, right.
The elders are scared.
No, all it means is that right now, if somebody wants to make a film, in the old days, if somebody wanted to make a film about how you sit in your seat in the American Airlines plane and buckle your seatbelt, there are only a few filmmakers who knew how to, you know, they knew the technology to take the picture and. Anybody can do that now. So the low end is, you know, there's a lot of people there, and probably you probably can't make much money at it. In the old days, you had a business.
I think they're forcing us to be better filmmakers.
Good.
Yes,
that's good.
Right, but still, I think this concept of being fearful, and I get this a lot, you know. And also, I got to say that a lot of young people, you know, call me and go, you know, I would like to come and work at Zacuto. And I'm like, okay, what do you want to do? And they're like, direct. I'm like, well, what am I going to do then? You know, there's not a lot of this, like, I want to start at the bottom and, be, you know, potentially a best boy someday and move up from there, you know.
Right. A lot of the respect for the craft is out because people don't quite understand what it is.
Well, because you gave him a camera when he's 10 and now he feels he can direct.
Yeah.
That's what I'm getting at.
Well, he's just going to have that rude awakening where he doesn't.
Yeah, I think so.
I don't even think they know what directing is. I get it all the time, same thing as you. Like, I want to do what you do. Look, you don't even know what I do.
You know what they don't realize?
You like my car, and that's why you want to do what I do. So,
You like my car. Yeah,
you like my car.
So wait, no, if I make short films like you, I can get a nice car?
No, that's not a money-making venture.
What's your money-making venture?
Promos, commercial stuff, nice. Corporate stuff.
What's your money-making venture?
I haven't figured that out yet.
Commercials, yeah, really promos.
Commercial. I survived doing commercials for a while. And you know, actually, making those documentary commercials is a lot of fun.
But if you had a chance, you've made these wonderful small films that I'd love to see. Now I'm going to see because I have a good curator here.
It won't take
up
much time of your life.
But no, but here's the deal. If
you, ooh, I like what he just said. They're not going to take much time of your
that's
life.
That's the whole reason.
But that's what I wanted to know. Would you want to make a bigger film and then you feel okay?
So I guess that goes back to rules. Why does a film have to be 90 minutes? This story took 7.5 minutes
absolutely
to make.
Right. Look, you have a sonnet, 14 lines.
Yeah,
you don't need more than four.
Form should follow content.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what I was telling you before. Like they're kind of like songs. You know, it's just like kind of. You just take a look at it and it kind of sticks with you.
You're a sculptor. You find out what you amass something and then you go.
Here it is.
Do you ever feel? Geez, this is a story that's got to be bigger.
I don't know. Everyone says that to me. I'm like, no, not really.
I don't feel like he needs a second more in the pieces he makes.
Well, that's what I think, too. But then at the Q&As, I say this, and people think I'm an asshole. So,
well, then you're doing the right thing.
More people will see this than anything I could ever do that would go in a theater.
So,
that's what means something to me.
And this came up in a previous film, Fellas, once. Would you rather have 26,000 people watch your thing in a movie theater or 500,000 hits on the internet?
I'm just going to put it in the movie theater because I think it looks like, especially we live in public, but Dig was cool too and Join Us is cool. We live in public. It's so visually mind-blowing. So I feel like it deserves the cinema, and I feel like people who really love this subject matter or want to see the film, they have their shot. If they make it in that week or two that we're in the movie theater, then they can. And you know what? It'll come out on DVD.
Yes? You would rather have 26,000 people watch this?
I can have it all. I can have 26,000.
You're not getting 500,000 views, and
of course I'm going to have. I'm going to have more than that by the time this movie's out.
It's possible. But
I'm going to put it out on DVD. We're going to have an internet.
No, but we're talking about in the theater.
I'm never going to get that in the theater.
I know. I'm just saying.
But I'm going to get it on YouTube later. Yeah.
So he wants to know which you want. Sort of like when they asked Yogi Berra.
I'm doing exactly what I want.
Best, you know, offensive team, or do you want the best, you know, defense? He says, well, you know, I'd like the pitch in as long as I can have the hidden.
I want as many people to see it as possible. But I want to give people an opportunity to see it as a film in a theater, in a setting where they're not isolated looking at their computer screen because the film's about isolation. So I love the fact that we see it together.
I was actually kind of surprised at how technically difficult. I wasn't expecting that. Yeah. I mean, she's got like, you know, at one point, you know, 150 individual little videos playing on the screen at once, you know, even in your logo.
We cut 5,000 hours of footage for We Live in Public in 8 months. Because I really spent 8 years going, you know, I really don't know how this movie's relevant to you and you and you, you know? So I didn't make the film. And when I realized it was when I saw Facebook status update, and it was like this lightning bolt. Oh my God, I have to make this movie right now, and I know exactly what it's about. And so tearing through 5,000 hours with a killer team, it was like boom, 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 out, 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 out. Like 5,000 hours, you know? I landed at Sundance on my knees. I was like, whoop. All of a sudden I was there, terrible sound mix, and we just did it.
I mean, like, so we got her take on your audience. Let's say your audience, I don't want to say it's shrinking.
Mm-hmm. The PBS audience is shrinking, yeah.
Does that bother you?
Yeah, I think it's a pity, you know. It does bother me. I mean, you have to remember, I mean, all of us, the first thing we want to do is make the movie. I mean, we love making movies, and we really want to make the movie, and we're working like crazy. It doesn't mean we don't want it to get seen. We really do. But the thing that drives you first is loving this medium and the subject and being in it. So, you know, it's not like we're planning the party before we make the movie. You know, there's some people, sometimes a sponsor of a film, they say they're sort of talking about the party and you haven't done the movie yet. And I'm always thinking, geez, I got to make the movie. I want the movie to be good. Okay, so now it's done. I mean, I think it would be great if there were ways to get it, you know, in other forms. Look, I mean, I did a film that's 6 hours long, this one about the Jewish Americans. I think every Jewish person in America has seen a little bit of it.
Everyone has seen that.
Know? But who could watch all of it, you know? But
I watched all of it.
You did.
My folks watched all of it.
Okay.
Every Jew in America watched every fucking minute of that thing, okay?